441 power 1 by 2 into 207 into 343 power 1 by 3 divided by 14 square into, right, this is 14 squared into 529 power 1 by 2 equals to what? Now, how do you solve this question? Apply the Bodmas rule. What does the rule say? First, to always go for the bracketed part. You have to simplify what is within the brackets. Now, here we have got different brackets. Again, remember, within brackets also, there is some hierarchy that we need to follow. For example, you know, there are different brackets. There is something called as flower brackets. Then we have square brackets. Then curved brackets, right? The general brackets that we use, right? So, in general, it's always an inside-out operation. When there are multiple brackets, like in this case, within the brackets, we have got brackets, right? Here again, within the flower brackets, we have got simple brackets there. So, whenever there are multiple brackets, always try to go inside out, right? The operation is inside out, right? So, enter the innermost bracket and try to keep moving outwards. That's the logic. And in general, the hierarchy here is that always simplify this kind of bracket first. Then go for square ones and then go for flower ones. But you need not, you know, try to remember this or mug it up. Just remember, inside whatever, within the brackets, whatever is there in the bracket part, try to simplify. And then keep moving outwards and you will get the right answer. Okay? Strictly speaking, the rule is not BODMA. The rule is VBODMA. But generally, this is not required when we are doing these calculations. What does this V stand for? V stands for vinculum. This is another kind of bracket. For example, 4 plus 6 minus 3. And if it is given this way, this is known as a vinculum, right? A bracket. This is a kind of special bracket. So 4 plus 6 is actually inside the brackets here. That's the idea, right? Generally, when we say 3.3 bar, what does it mean? 3.3333. So that's the idea. That's what is called as bar. But here, this is not acting as a bar. This is called vinculum, where we add 4 and 6 first. 10 minus 3. 7 will be the answer, right? You cannot take something else. Like, for example, anyway, here, even if you take 6 minus 3 plus 4, we'll give you the same answer, but that would be wrong, right? Let's say if it is multiplication, right? So if you say 6 into 3, 18, 18 plus 4, 22 is the wrong answer. Why? 4 and 6 are inside the bracket. 10 into 3, 30 is the correct answer. So that's what is known as vinculum, but generally not required. You don't have to worry about that part. Anyway, you have understood what is meant by that. So try to simplify this part now. You should have got the answer by now, right? Look at this. 441 power 1 by 2. Power 1 by 2 means what? Square root, right? Half. Power half is what? Square root. What is square root of 441? 21. What is power 1 by 3? Cube root. What is cube root of 343? 7. 7 cube is 343. Likewise here, 14 squared, 196. Again, understand, these are all known as, this is what stands for O. B-O-D-M-A-S. What is O? The other operations of exponents, powers, indices, right? All this comes under that O part, right? Other operations of orders and these kind of operations. So, square root, cube root, square root, all this comes under O, right? So, 529 square root. What is square root of 529? 23. Yes or no? 23 square is 529. This is 23, right? So, 21 into 207 into 7 divided by 196 into 23. Yes or no? 14 square is 196 into 23. 529 square root is 23. Now, try to simplify this. What do you see? If you really look at it, 21 into 207 into 7 divided by 196 into 23. Yes or no? 196 into 23. Now, someone who is really good in calculations, he would know that 23 goes 9 times in 207. Yes or no? You don't have to worry about 23 into 10, 230, minus 23 is 207. 9 times. Right? What about, what else can be done here? 9 does it get cancelled in 196? No. 7? Yes. 7 goes how many times in 196? 7 goes how many times? 140 and how much is that? 140 and 56. So, 28 times. 21 by 28. This is 3 times and 4 times. So, overall, this is 3 by 4 into 9. What is 3 fourth of 9? 6.75. Yes or no? 3 fourth of 8 is 2. So, 3 fourth of 8 is 6. 3 fourth of 1 is 0.75. So, 6 plus 0.75, 6.75. So, the answer for this one is 6.75. So, this is all what you need to do. Simple calculations. Try to do it as quickly as possible. Follow the Bodmas rule and you will be getting the right answers.